Hi all, welcome to another episode of Saturday Architecture. Happy New Year. So I thought at the beginning of the new year, we always do resolutions. So instead of a personal resolution, let me make an architectural resolution. As an architect, what do we resolve to do? And I decided that in Hypoha, what we have is something called a green zone task. Things which are kind of important to do, but if you don't do it, there is no penalty or there's no great reward for doing it, neither there is a punishment. Okay. But if you don't do it in that time, over a period of time, you will start paying the tax for it. So one thing which I realized as an architect is that I have not been, as a team, I have not helped creating a structure for the team to learn and prepare for something coming ahead. Like, am I going to be ready for a capability which I would need 6 months later or a year later? So that could be learning, it could be a POC, it could be validating a concept, any of these things, right? I've never quite done that. And so I kind of made a resolution that, you know, I'm going to enable the learning of my team by having at least, by making one monthly connect, right, which is just focused on a half an hour connect, half an hour monthly, just focused on, we call it green zone, which means it can be a POC, learning, whatever. So I'm going to schedule a monthly connect of half an hour with my team, where we quickly come around and then probably spend 15 minutes on the previous monthly sprint, how well we have progressed as far as the green zone. And another 15 minutes on, teams can talk about new technologies, new approaches, which they would either want to learn or practice with each other. So I would call that as a green zone stand-up, which I would do every month. So that's something that I resolved to do this one, this year. And the other thing is, in terms of bringing up big blocks of epic identification, we haven't done that very well. Yeah, there are shorter sprints, tasks which is there, we kind of do that. But a religious disciplined way of doing grooming of epic level stuff, and especially in a org like me where it's business is driven, it's product driven, there's no really customers asking for feature, a lot of things tend to meander along. So I thought, like, every quarter, at least every quarter, I would do a grooming of features and requests to kind of prioritize what we need to do. So it's like, as of now, it's like we take, it's not bad that every day I get up, but it's just that it's probably fortnightly or weekly. I think I have to make that. We have a vision of week or a fortnight, but I have to get it up to a quarter kind of a thing. So we have a plan for a quarter. We have a plan for a month or 2 weeks. So I think I need to do that. So in both these cases, it's a classical thing. We are just responding to what is happening, which is a yellow kind of thing, being reactive in nature. So becoming more greener, let's say.
Do you think OKR will help in this? How do you actually intend to achieve it?
I think that is
can OKR help?
OKR will definitely help. OKR will definitely help. So for the quarterly things, which I think I'm putting, even for the learning, I think that's actually a good point. Probably that's what I would kind of crystallize into at the end of a green zone stand-up meeting and at the end of a quarterly triage. Transfer it onto the OKRs so that it gets tracked. It's not, maybe it's not a biblical following of the OKR, but I think it's a good start for me and my team. So
I think there's nothing biblical about OKR themselves. So, actually, the reason I think it is probably one of the more successful strategies for doing medium term planning is because it's not very prescriptive. It lets you means, of course, there'll be successful formulas and unsuccessful formulas, but the prescription is actually very light in terms of what OKR intends to do. So I that's why I like it for such purposes.
Thanks. Yeah, surely I'll do that.
So for me, because I don't have literally have a team to work with, so I can focus only on myself, and of course there are lots of things. I'm usually not the point in time resolution kind of a person, right? This is just my way of working. For me, the new year usually has never been a very important event for me as such, right? So for me, if something has to happen, it just happens. If I decide to do something and I say, okay, tomorrow just this is it, and I'm just starting to do this now, right? And there are, of course, multiple threads we keep meandering around like everybody else. But for me, the starting is never an issue. So it's only the finishing and the continuing which is an issue. So last year I spent quite some time building one hobby application. Right, I taught myself Python. I learned how to program it. I put that application on Azure. I have now at least 3-4 users who are not me, right? So I have reached that level. And my sort of the purpose of that application was to, one is to learn how to do, how to build a web application. Right, that was one purpose. Other was to see how we can convert this into a machine learning opportunity. So for me to learn something, I have to either do it by hand. The theory just doesn't cut with me. If I just read enough or watch enough videos or listen to enough audio, I will be able to sort of grasp it. And I cannot internalize it unless I do it with my hand. So I have to just do it. So now this year's resolution is to see how I can use machine learning with this application which I've built. So that's my resolution, to see a real life application for machine learning. Of course, I may have to learn new things, right? So I'm expecting not to learn new kinds of mathematics, but sort of I go with the minimalist tools approach. What is the minimal level of knowledge I need to go to implement machine learning in my system? So that's what my resolution is for this year.
Any thoughts on, okay, let me at least prescribed certifications. Let me do one or two related to machine learning so it gives me a structure.
Yeah, that actually is Microsoft has lots of free online courses for that. So that's what I will probably start there and complete a few of them. And I did subscribe to one distribution list which is teaching machine learning using email. So I did subscribe to it.
Oh,
but
okay.
Honestly, I have not been able to follow through on any of those.
So the rule takes it to that folder and it's safely kept in that folder.
No, it just means it comes to my Gmail account and it just sits there. I just know that it is there. And I'm also very OCD about unread email. So I, every time I see it in my mailbox, it reminds me. It hurts me
guilty
that I'm not
bad.
Yes, guilty and bad. So one day it will happen. So because I was sort of there are a lot of justifications why I did not do it, but I have to do it. So that's the resolution.
I think one of the interesting things, one guy once joking and in a time management thing, he's like, so somebody said one day, he says, there's no one day, there's a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, there's no one day in life for the universe.
Exactly.
Just tell which day, don't say one day.
the thing is that there's always there's so many open threads and books to finish and all these things. So like a multi-threaded operating system, I have to pick up the thread at whenever.
I think you're already good at synchronization. I think probably just one anchor, right? So in the habit thing, you have an anchor action, right? So the anchor can be like second Saturday, 15 minutes.
I saw Sukumar's video on habit formation. I remember that, and I actually used that to a great effect, I would say. So what he said is before something or after something, right? If you associate that habit to something which you're already a habit, so you can do before that or after that, then it becomes linked to that activity itself and it becomes a habit.
After that, it's a little more easier. Before that is a little harder, right? Because that event has already passed.
Yes.
So after that works even better.
Yeah, I mean, the concept, I actually liked that and I used it and it worked. So that's what I have to probably think of. How do I associate it with the something which I already do and finish doing it.
Great.
And there are so many other resolutions.
All the best to both of us for getting this done.
Yes. So now we have declared, now we have to do it.
Yes. Thanks all for joining. And please do share what your architectural decision will be in the comments. When you see this, we'll be glad to see it. Probably we'll get inspired and somebody else will get inspired by your resolution. So you're doing a favor to yourself and to others by declaring. So I would really encourage you to just make that declaration to the world. Inspire yourself, inspire others. Let's have a great 2021. Thanks all for joining.
Thank you.
Okay. So I will...